Good afternoon, welcome to the Daily Office, and thanks for joining me. This is evening prayer for Tuesday, December 16th. It's the third week in Advent, and the scripture for this service, Psalms 47 and 48, and Luke chapter 22, verse 54 to 69. And please join me in singing verse 3 of On Jordan's Bank.
For thou art our salvation, Lord, our refuge and our great reward. Without thy grace we waste away like flowers that wither and decay.
O God, come to my assistance. Make haste to help me. Glory to you, source of all being, eternal word and Holy Spirit, as in the beginning, so now and forever. Amen. Clap your hands, all you people. Cry out to God with shouts of joy. Psalms 47 and 48, and please recite them together with me. Clap your hands, all you people. Cry out to God with shouts of joy. For you, Most High, are to be feared, a great ruler over all the earth. You subdue the people under us and the nations under our feet. You chose our inheritance for us, given to Jacob, Leah, and Rachel, whom you loved. God goes up with a shout, the Most High with the sound of a trumpet. Sing praises to God, sing praises. Sing praises to our ruler, sing praises. For God is the ruler of all the earth. Sing praises with all your skill. God reigns over the heathen, who sits enthroned in holiness. And the leaders of the people are gathered, the people of the God of Abraham and Sarah. For the rulers of the earth belong to God, who is greatly exalted. My God, you are great and greatly to be praised in the city of your holy mountain. Mount Zion is beautiful and the joy of the whole earth, for there is the city of the great King. You are known as a refuge in her palaces, for the kings were assembled. They passed by together. They saw it and were amazed. They were troubled and hurried away. Fear took hold of them there, and pain like that of a woman in labor, like the ships of Tarshish shattered by an east wind. As we have heard, so we have seen, in the city of God Most High of Hosts, in the city of our God, God will establish her forever. We have waited on your loving kindness, O God, in the midst of your temple. Your praise, like your name, reaches to the ends of the earth. Your right hand is full of righteousness. Let Mount Zion rejoice. Let the daughters of Judah be glad because of your judgments. Walk around Zion and go all around her. Count her towers. Mark her bulwarks and consider her palaces, that you may tell the next generation. For this God is our God forever and ever, and will be our guide until death. Glory to you, source of all being, eternal word, and Holy Spirit, as in the beginning, so now and forever. Amen. Clap your hands, all you people. Cry out to God with shouts of joy. A lesson from the Holy Gospel according to Luke, chapter 22, beginning at verse 54. Then they seized Jesus and led him away, bringing him into the high priest's house. But Peter was following at a distance. When they had kindled a fire in the courtyard and sat down together, Peter sat among them. And then a servant girl, seeing him in the firelight, stared at him and said, "This man was also with them." But Peter denied it, saying, "Woman, I do not know him." A little while later, Someone else on seeing him said, "You also are one of them." But Peter said, "Man, I am not." Then about an hour later, still another kept insisting, "Surely this man was also with him, for he is a Galilean." But Peter said, "I do not know what you are talking about." And at that moment, while he was still speaking, the cock crowed. The Lord turned and looked at Peter, and then Peter remembered the word, how he had said to him, "Before the cock crows today, you will deny me three times." And he went out and wept bitterly. Now the men who were holding Jesus began to mock him and beat him. And they also blindfolded him and kept asking him, "Prophesy, who is it that struck you?" As they kept heaping many other insults on him. And when day came, the assembly of the elders and the people, both the chief priests and the scribes gathered together, and they brought Jesus to their council. And they said, "If you are the Messiah, tell us." And he replied, "If I tell you, you will not believe. And if I question you, you will not answer. But from now on, the Son of Man will be seated at the right hand of the power of God." All of them asked, "Are you then the Son of God?" And he said to them, "You say that I am." And then they said, "What further testimony do we need? We have heard it ourselves from his own lips." Here ends the lesson. And now let us offer our prayers and petitions. And please say the response after each verse. Show us your mercy, O God, and grant us your salvation. Let your priests be clothed with righteousness, and let your saints shout for joy. In you shall we lie down in peace and sleep, for only you make us dwell in safety. Make us a righteous nation that keeps your truth, that we may glory in your judgment. Let your way be known upon the earth, your saving health among all nations. Let not the needy be always forgotten, nor the hope of the poor perish forever. Create in us clean hearts, O God, and renew a right spirit within us, and for all of your intentions. Together. Our beloved, which art in heaven, holy is your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us as we forgive others. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Let us pray. Almighty and everlasting God, accept our praises, for we have seen your justice and are glad in you. Be our guide from this day to the next, now and forever. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Bless Jesus, my soul. And may the God of hope fill us with all joy and peace in believing through the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen.